Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to give you an overview of the different AWS certifications and talk about which certifications you should concentrate on gaining. So, which certifications should you get? Well, at the foundational level with AWS, we have what's called the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. This certification is suitable for anyone who's a complete beginner. Okay, so it is foundational level. It does start at the very basics. So if you're new to tech, new to IT, new to cloud computing, this is definitely the place to start. You'll learn the foundational concepts of the cloud, the benefits of the cloud, the various different pricing models, different types of cloud service like infrastructure as a service and platform as a service and software as a service. If you don't know what those things are, this is definitely the place to start. Now, it is suitable for those in non-hands-on roles. So for example, you might be a project manager working in a company that deploys the cloud. And so you're involved in projects moving things to cloud. In that case, it's useful to have an understanding of the cloud, but you don't need to be a technical expert. Similarly, you might be working in a marketing team of a company that's selling cloud solutions. So it's useful to understand the advantages of cloud computing. Now, you will learn some fundamental hands-on skills when doing this certification, especially in our courses, but you don't need to have a very strong practical knowledge. So practical expertise not required for the exam. It's more theoretical and the questions are very straightforward. Great place to start for anyone who is new to cloud computing. Some concepts are not covered in other certifications, so there is a bit of assumed knowledge as you move up through the intermediate, the pro, and the specialty levels. So that's why it is good for everyone to start here, if you can. Next up, we have the associate certifications. There are three associate level certifications. We have the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate. This is by far the most popular AWS certification. Then we have the AWS Certified SysOps Administrator Associate, and then we have the Developer Associate. So as you can see, these are designed for specific roles. If you're a solutions architect, then the solutions architect certification is suitable for you. If the SysOps is your role, then obviously the SysOps Administrator and then the developer. Okay, so it's all about specific roles within the jobs that you're doing. However, don't get too caught up on that because I think it's useful to earn all of these certifications. So this is an intermediate level certification. It does assume that you already have some existing cloud or tech skills. It's recommended to start with a Solutions Architect Associate, and then from there, it's fairly straightforward to go on and do the other two. So my recommendation is certainly to do all three certifications. That will give you a broader understanding of AWS. Doesn't matter if you're a SysOps administrator, developer, or a solutions architect, or some other job role in the cloud. Going for all three will just mean a broader knowledge and more experience as you practice with the technologies as you go through the training. So also the overlap between them is fairly significant. So once you've done one, then you'll typically, for instance, spend a lot more time on your first associate certification, for example, the Solutions Architect Associate, and then you can quite quickly take the other two because the differences between them aren't that great. Above that, we have the professional certifications. So these are pretty difficult exams. We've got the Solutions Architect Professional, and we've got the DevOps Engineer Professional. These are suitable for those who have significant hands-on experience. Do not jump straight in here. Now, I should say that there are no prerequisites for any AWS exam, so you can go straight to the professional level if you choose to, but you're going to be making your life pretty difficult. Okay, these are definitely challenging exams. It's recommended to do all three associates first. That's my recommendation. So I would say do all three associates before you tackle either of these exams because they are very difficult. They'll test your knowledge and they'll test your experience as well. If there are any gaps in your knowledge, you'll certainly find out in the exam. I think the DevOps Pro is slightly easier. So if you are going to go for all associates and if you're planning on doing both professional levels, then perhaps the DevOps Pro should be the one that you do first. Finally, we then have the specialty certifications. These kind of sit alongside the professional level, if you like. They are similar in difficulty, though the difficulty can vary quite widely. So here we have specializations. We've got the advanced networking, security, machine learning, data analytics, database, and then SAP on AWS. So these are suitable for those with specialist IT skills. If you come from a networking background, then for example, the advanced networking would make perfect sense for you. If your role is around security and your company is going into the cloud, then of course you'll want to do the security specialty. Same with machine learning, data analytics, and the others. These are also for those who are looking to specialize. So you might just want to go into these roads. You might find that machine learning is an extremely exciting area to be in today. So of course, you can learn the machine learning through doing this certification. However, it's recommended that you do at least one associate first. So don't go straight into advanced networking just because you come from a networking background. You have to learn the fundamentals of AWS first, because otherwise you just won't understand the makeup of AWS, the various services and configuration. The difficulty can vary quite widely. The advanced networking, for example, is a pretty difficult exam. Security is a bit easier. It really varies quite a lot. Now, a lot of people ask, is a certification enough to get a job today? The short answer is no. So it's not enough because there are so many people who have certifications. It's relatively easy to get AWS certifications, especially at the foundational and then the intermediate level. So there are a lot of people out there who are certified today. So unfortunately, that doesn't cut it. That's not going to be enough to get a job on its own. It is expected, though. So if other candidates have certifications and you don't, then that's not going to go in your favor. Job candidates need to have broad skills as well across multiple technologies and platforms. So these days, you will find that most job roles for the cloud, even junior roles, will have a number of different technologies and services that you need to understand. Typically, my recommendation would be to go broad rather than deep and gain skills across those different technologies rather than becoming an uber expert at AWS and gaining several certifications. Get one, two, three of those, but also go and learn some of the other technologies as well. And build a portfolio of experience that you can then demonstrate to employers. This is absolutely critical. So even if you're not working and getting paid for it, there are ways to build a portfolio that you can demonstrate to employers to show that you have the skills that they need. So let's have a look at some of those additional skills that are very useful. So Windows is a skill set that a lot of people have. Linux, not quite so much. And yet Linux is the most widely used operating system in the cloud, even on Microsoft Azure. So Linux really is a key operating system. You need to know your way around the Linux command line. Infrastructure as code, so services like CloudFormation in AWS and Terraform, which works across multiple clouds and platforms. These are really useful tools to understand so you know how to automate the deployment of applications and infrastructure in the cloud. Containers as well. Lots of workloads today will run on Docker, Kubernetes, Amazon ECS, AWS Fargate as well. So you've got to understand these technologies. Programming languages are very useful. Now, you don't necessarily have to be a programming expert if you're going into, for instance, a solutions architect role, but it's useful to have some fundamental skills that will make your life much easier, even if it's just when you're building test applications and building your skill set. So Python and Node.js are two very useful skills. And then lastly, DevOps and continuous integration and continuous delivery tools. Things like the AWS developer tools, code pipeline, code build, code deploy, and code commit. Git, of course, as well. And sometimes external tools outside of AWS, things like Jenkins and Puppet and other technologies similar to those. So those are really useful skill sets. You will find that when you look for cloud job roles, you're going to see these technologies coming up quite a lot. Now, how can you get experience? Because I mentioned before that experience is key to getting a job. Well, of course, use training courses that include challenging hands-on exercises. In all of our training courses at Digital Cloud Training, we make sure that we cover lots of hands-on exercises so you build that practical experience. You can also find example projects online, places like Medium and the AWS website for AWS-specific solutions. lots of articles out there, those sort of hands-on tutorials to help you to give you some ideas and some guidance on how to actually build something. You can also use pre-configured challenges in sandbox environments like the Skillable Challenge Labs that we sell on our website. Those help you to both learn but also validate your skills. So you're actually building according to a challenge. The Challenge Labs have thousands of labs which cover a broad set of technologies. And lastly, but most importantly, I think, is bootcamp. So we run bootcamps at Digital Cloud Training. And the reason we started doing that, despite having hundreds of thousands of people enrolled in our training courses, is that bootcamps are the way to make the difference. So this is how you can really build real-world applications, real-world skills in a classroom environment with guidance and supervision from those with lots of industry experience, giving you those assignments, working with you on them in live sessions. That is really a key differentiator. It's a way to really build those hands-on skills and that portfolio that you can then demonstrate to employers. So we have a bootcamp program called the Cloud Mastery Bootcamp. Within this bootcamp, you gain practical cloud skills with real world hands-on scenarios. You learn key cloud skills, including those ones that we just looked at. So AWS, Linux, Python, infrastructure as code, containers, and you get multiple AWS certifications. You get to join a cohort of other learners and follow a structured learning path over several months. You get to develop a portfolio of experience that you can showcase to employers. That's really one of those critical things that if you're not working in the industry and actually gaining that experience on a daily basis, then how are you going to demonstrate that to employers? And they're always asking for experience in most job descriptions. You also get to learn from industry experts with decades of experience. Obviously, the value of that is huge because there's no greater way to learn than to be around those who have significant experience. And lastly, of course, you get to gain access to expert support throughout that journey because you're working in that environment where you have expert assistance all the time. So I hope that video is useful and that's given you a bit of an insight into not only which certifications to focus on, but also some of the other skills that you should learn and how you might go about doing it.